Welcome to another Blender tutorial. My name is Raymond Gabriel, and in this series, I will be showing you how to create a Minion character from the Despicable Me movie using Blender. I will be going through everything from modeling, texturing, and rigging. I will also be showing you how to create a walk cycle, a run cycle, an idle animation, and a jumping animation. Then, I will finish off the series by importing the animated character into Unity and control it as in a game environment. So, without any further delay, let's get right into it. I'll be using this reference image for the modeling part of the tutorial. If you want to follow along, you can download it from the description below. Okay, let's jump into Blender. Press A to select everything. Press X to delete. Now go to where you saved the reference. Drag and drop it inside of Blender, and that will drop the image. Now press Alt-R, that will remove the rotation. Press Alt-G, and that will reset the location as well. Now press R, then X, and then 90. Press G, then Z, and move it above the grid like that. Let's move it on the Y axis by pressing G, then Y, to move it back a little. What we need to do is put the front reference of the character in the front orthographic view, and the side on the right orthographic view. So press 1 on your numpad to switch to front view. Right now we are in the perspective view. If you press 5 on your numpad, that will switch it to orthographic. And you can also switch the view from view. From this option, you will switch between perspective and orthographic. Okay, now press G, then X, and move the front reference in the middle of the Z axis like that. Okay, now press Shift D, then Y to duplicate the reference. Press R, then Z, then 90 to rotate it. Press G, then X to move it like that. If you press 3 on your numpad, that will get you to the right orthographic. Press G, then Y, and move it until the Z axis is in the middle of the side reference like that. So, if I switch to front, you'll see that I will use the front reference. If I switch to the right, I will use the right reference. I can easily switch between the front orthographic and the right orthographic by just going to around where it's supposed to be and pressing Alt. That will snap it. I'll snap the view to the right orthographic. If I just went to the side of the front and pressed Alt on your keyboard, that will snap it to the front orthographic. That is just a quicker way to snap to the view that you want in 3D and not just using the shortcuts. You can always use the numpad 3 or 1 to switch between front and right. Okay, let's start by adding in a cube. Press Shift A and then from mesh, add in a cube. Okay, pull it up by pressing G, then Z, scale it down until it matches the width of the character reference. Press Z, then go to wireframe to be able to see the reference. Press Tab to go to edit mode, select the top vertices and press G, then Z, and match the top of the reference like that. Select the bottom ones and match the lower part of the reference like that. So what we need to do now is add a subdivision modifier. From the modifier tab here, select add modifier and put in a subdivision surface modifier. And that will try to smoothen out the cube and will make it like that. What we need to do now is just add supporting edges to support the top edge and the lower edge. Press Ctrl R and that should add a loop. If you put your mouse here at the edge, you'll see that there is a loop appearing in yellow color. If you press, you can see that I'm now able to move this loop. Pull it up like that until you get the curve that you want. Press Ctrl R again and add another loop for the lower part like that. Alright, press Tab to go to object mode. Press right click and shade smooth to smoothen out the shape. Scale it up by pressing S and try to match the reference behind. Maybe switch to the right orthographic. Go to edit mode by pressing Tab. Make sure that you are in wireframe and select the top vertices like that. The reason why I select the vertices in wireframe is that I need to make sure that I'm selecting all the vertices, even the ones at the back. Because if you are in the solid view and you try to select them, you will only select the ones that you are able to see, and the ones at the back will not be selected. So just make sure that you are in wireframe to select everything. Alright, now move it like that, rotate it by pressing R and try to match the reference behind. Maybe add an edge loop in this location. Press S, scale it down and move it on the Y axis like that. If you want to see edges respecting the smoothed out shape, go to where the modifier, the subdivision modifier is, and press this toggle, and that will make the vertices respect the smoothness, and that will make it much easier to adjust the shape of the cube. Okay, go to wireframe, select the bottom vertices and scale them up. Try to match the reference as much as possible. Maybe go to the front, select these vertices and pull them up like that. Scale them down a little. Maybe select this loop by pressing Alt, then left click. That will select all the loop. Scale it up. Okay, maybe add a loop in the middle of the character by pressing Ctrl R and press here. Then press Escape button to snap it in the middle of the character like that. But right now, you can see that the cube is starting to be visible and it's not rounded anymore. So to fix that, we need to make these loops circular. So to do that, we are going to use an add-on. So go to Edit, then Preference, and then from the Add-ons tab, search here for Loop, and you will find that there is an add-on called Loop Tools. Check here, then press Save Preference. That will add some new tools. If you press right click, you will see here in the loop tools, all these new tools have been added. What we can do with them is that we can select this loop by pressing Alt, then select the loop, press right click, and from loop tools select the circle. That will change the shape of the selection to a circle. So select the other loop, right click, loop tools, then circle. This one as well, right click, circle. Maybe the bottom ones as well. If you want to select multiple loops, press Alt, select one of them, then Alt Shift and hold and select the other loops as well. Right click, loop tools, circle. Now go to wireframe. I think it's much bigger now than the reference, so let's scale it down. Let's try to add a mirror modifier so that anything that we model on this side is mirrored to the other side. So go to edit mode, then go to wireframe, press 1 on your keyboard, that will switch to a vertex select. If you press 2, you will switch to edge select, 3 face select. So press 1 and then select these vertices, then press X and select vertices, and that will delete these vertices and we will have only half of the character. Now go to the add modifier tab here and select mirror. That will add the other half of the mesh. Right now, if we try to move this part, it will be mirrored to the other side. Make sure that you have the mirror modifier at the first of the modifier stack and not the last one. So select this arrow to make it the first one. You probably always need that the subdivision modifier to be the last one, so to avoid any problems with the mesh. Okay, so right now, if we select this loop and we try to move it, you will find that they are moving across each other and the mirror is trying to mirror the movement of this edge loop. So to avoid that, and we have this edge loop fixed in its location, we have to go to the mirror modifier and select clipping. That will select this edge loop to the mirrored one and they will never be moving across each other. Okay, so right now we need to extrude out the legs. So press 3 to switch to face select or press this toggle. Then go to this face, select it, press I to insert the faces inside, like that. Go to wireframe by pressing Z, then wireframe. Press 1 to switch to vertex select. Then press B for box select and select these vertices. Move them up by pressing G, then Z and match them with the reference, like that. Maybe move them on the X axis, press G, then X. And move them a little on the X axis like that. Press 3 to switch to face select again. Then select this face. Press I to insert again. Now press E to extrude it out. Press Z to lock it on the Z axis. Press E again, then Z. Okay, what we need to do now is flatten this face. So press S, then Z, then 0 to flatten this face out. Press 1 to switch to vertex select again. Press Alt and hold, then select this edge loop, S, Z, 0 to flatten it out as well. Press Alt, then press Shift, hold them down, then select this loop, select this loop, select these vertices, go to wireframe and scale them all down like that until they are matching with the leg in the reference. maybe go to the side reference and scale them on the Y axis as well, like that. Okay, let's extrude out the arms. So go to this face, select it, then go to wireframe, press I, and that will insert this face inside. Maybe we need to move it on the X axis like that to match with the front reference. Now press E to extrude it out. What we need to do is extrude the arm a little bit away from the body, because that will help us in rigging the character after that. We don't want to match the reference exactly at this point, so we just try to rotate and move it away from the body like that. Now press E again, that will extrude another face. E once more. Okay, so let's fix it from the side. Press 1, press Alt and select this loop, maybe select all the loops here, and press S then Y to scale them down on the Y axis like that. Okay, what we need to do here is add more edge loops, because this is where the elbow will be. So let's just match with the reference in the side view and try to put more edge loops in this part. Maybe add another one. Select these vertices and scale them up to match with the reference. Alright, I think this is good enough. Let's try and continue and model the gloves. So press shift and right click, so you can switch the 3D cursor to this position. If you press shift A and you add it in a cube, it will be added to the location of the 3D cursor. Scale the cube down. We'll try to model it first from this reference and then move it to the front reference. Okay, so move the cube, rotate it, then scale it up. Go to edit mode, then go to wireframe. Select these vertices, move them down like that, then scale them up and match this part of the reference. Alright, now press E again and pull it to the beginning of this finger and scale it down until it's matching with these two points. What we have here is right now we have three faces. Face here, another one here, and another one here. We can extrude them out to make these fingers. So press E on each one of them, and that will create the base of the finger. Maybe scale it up like that. The last one, rotate and scale. Okay, maybe go to wireframe, select these vertices, and scale them up like that. Let's add the subdivision modifier to smooth it out. Press right click and shade smooth. Let's add edge loops to define the shape a little more. So add one here, go to wireframe, select these vertices and pull them up here. Maybe select this edge loop and fatten it out like that to match with the reference. Let's do the same thing with the other fingers as well. Put an edge loop here and scale it out like that. Another edge loop here. Okay. Maybe add another edge loop to support this edge. Hit wireframe, select these edges. You will find that I'm switching between solid and wireframe quickly by pressing Z. Alright, now select these two vertices, pull them out like that so they are a little matching with the reference. Go to object mode, press G then X and move them on the X axis like that and the Y axis as well, and match them with the location of the hand. Maybe rotate them on the Z axis to match it with the reference now. So rotate it on the Z axis like that. Rotate it like that. Scale it up. Maybe select this face and try to move it on the X axis like that. If you want to pull it and pull all the vertices around it relative to it, you can use proportional editing, and that is a very handy tool and we will be using it a lot in the next parts. So if you press O on your keyboard, that will enable proportional editing from here, or you can just press this toggle. What will that do is that when you press G on your keyboard, you will see this circle appear. That defines how much of influence this selection will have on the vertices around it. I can control the size of this circle by the scroll button. So if you scroll your mouse like that, you will decrease the influence of this selection on the vertices around it. If you make it bigger, you will increase the influence. So make them around here, and then maybe put it on the x-axis like that, or maybe rotate it on the z-axis like that, so it's matching with the reference a little. Okay, maybe select this face, press I to insert the faces, maybe press I again, then press E to extrude it down like that, maybe close the proportional editing and scale it down like that, maybe move it up. Let's try and move these edges up here, because we need to have the elbow in the center of the arm and not down there. So let's move this edge up by pressing G, G, and move this one down. Maybe move this one up a little like that. You need to have at least 3 edge loops at each joint. So this will be the joint of the elbow. We have this one in the middle, and then we have this one and this one supporting it. So we have better deformation when we rig this part of the model. Let's try and model the shoes. Press shift and right click, put the 3D cursor here, shift A, then add a cube, scale it down and put it right here, then move it on the x-axis to match it with the front reference. Go to edit mode by pressing tab. Okay, then go to wireframe, press Ctrl R to add an edge loop around here, select this face and extrude it out like that. Now add a subdivision modifier so it's smooth this shape out. Press Ctrl R and add an edge loop to support the vertices at the bottom of the shoe. Maybe add an edge loop around here. Press 1 to go to vertex select, go to wireframe, select these vertices and move them up like that. Maybe press the right click and add shade smooth. Maybe we need to fatten it a little from the middle, so add an edge loop in the middle and scale it on the x-axis like that. Okay, let's extrude out these parts of the shoe. So let's first add more edge loops here, and then select these faces and extrude by pressing E. Go to the front view, press R, and Z, and match it with the rotation of the shoe like that. Maybe we also need to move it on the Y axis and the X axis to put it in the correct position of the leg. Now go to edit mode, maybe select these faces and pull them up like that. Maybe add an edge loop and support it like that. We need to match this part of the reference, so select these vertices, maybe pull them back like that. And also here, I think it's good enough for now.
That's it for this part. I hope that you found it useful. In the next part, we will continue modeling the character. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content like this. I will see you soon in the next part.